Bless the Lord. Praise God. Sorry for the late start this morning, but we're going to make up for it. Make sure we get adequate time in the Word. Hallelujah. And do what we need to do to get people in the position with the Lord. We thank you for those who are joining us online and those who are here that are here to connect with us and allow the grace of the Lord to flow in the house and over the lives of His people, to sharpen their faith and their fellowship and walk with the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so I'm really encouraged and excited about this, because I know that what God is about to do is something awesome, and what He has already done is just a testimony of what is going to happen. Hallelujah. We know that it's not all doom and gloom. Hallelujah. It's doom and gloom for those who don't believe, but for those who believe, it is the power of God unto salvation. And I tell you, the gospel is filled with that. Amen. And we preach the gospel of Christ, which is the gospel of the kingdom of God. And we believe that as you hear more about that kingdom and more about what the Lord has prepared for you in Christ Jesus, then it should awaken your faith, cause faith to rise in your hearts, and greater expectancy for miracles, the supernatural, and for God's purpose to be fulfilled in your life. Amen. Praise God. Well, we're going to acknowledge our Father right now. Come on, lift your hands to Him and just acknowledge Him where you are right now. Father, we just thank you for another occasion to come together as your people and to worship you in spirit and in truth. We live and breathe for this, because this is what we are made for. We are made for your praise. We are made for your glory. We are made for your honor, God. Everything in creation was made to glorify you. And so we praise you for bringing us into existence and having such a great plan and purpose over our life. For you said it is your good pleasure to give to us the kingdom. Hallelujah. You have not given it to angels, but you have given it to us as men, O God, who you have called to become your children. And so we embrace the word, O God, and said, be magnified, be glorified in all this. Let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Direct and order our thoughts and our speech and our word, our life aright, O God, in alignment with your plan and your purpose of your word. Breathe into us, hallelujah, your eternal life. Cause it to increase more and more and more and more. Hallelujah. Because that life is eternal. Hallelujah. And we embrace that life in Christ. Hallelujah. You said those who have the Son have that life. Hallelujah. And we thank you for that life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because it's in Him we move and we breathe and have our being. And we thank you, God, that things are lining up now. Things are coming in order. Things are coming into place, oh God, for that great unveiling, hallelujah, of the glorious appearance of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That great unveiling of the sons of God into the universe. Hallelujah. He said all creation is waiting for that. Hallelujah. That glorious unveiling. And we praise you, God, for what you're doing in our hearts. Hallelujah. The patience you have administered to us in waiting and in grooming and in building and in pruning and in shaping us. Hallelujah. In your will and in Christ Jesus. We praise you for it, Daddy. We thank you for making it available to us. Hallelujah. Many heard as we heard, but they did not mix it with faith. And we thankful that you gave release grace to us, that faith, hallelujah, could be released in us to tap into the grace and to release the power in our lives. And so we thank you for this day. We say this is the day you have made, and we rejoice and be glad in it. So magnify yourself, Father. Let bodies be healed, souls be saved, minds be renewed, and spirit man be built up, and cause your favor to shine in this house. Increase us more and more. Cause us to make a spoil of the enemy's camp today. Hallelujah. As the praises go up, cause us to relieve more people out of the hand of the enemy. Hallelujah. For you said, when one stronger comes, he's able to bind that strong man and to divide his house. Hallelujah. And so help us, Lord, to strike with accuracy, hallelujah, with pinpoint precision in the enemy's camp, and release the captives and cause that are broken to be healed and made whole, and that grace will be released for the salvation of more souls today in Jesus' name. Come on, give him the praise right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Are we going to do some praise and worship and set the atmosphere for what God is going to do today? Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Okay. That's very low. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. You're ready to praise him in here. My God, my God, my God. All right, let me get my sound in order. All right, come on. Hands together, come on, let's give God some praise today. You're happy about it, come on, let's praise him. Hallelujah. God is good, God is good. Woo! Come on. Good, 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 good. God is good, God is good. Come on. Fix me up. Fix me up. Turn me around. Come on. God is good. God is good. Hey. He's good. Good God. Fix me up, fix me up. Bless my feet. He is a miracle working. Come on, he is a miracle working God. God is a wonder. Come on. Woo! Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's a miracle working. Yeah. God is a wonder. Good God. That he's above blue, far behind and around us. He's above blue, far behind and around us. God is a wonder. Yes, sir. Oh, he is a miracle working. Yes, sir. What a God could. God is a wonder. Yes, sir. Don't try to tell me God is dead, he woke me up. Hey, don't try to tell me he's not alive, he lives within my heart. He opened up, yes, and set on my way. Don't try to tell me. I just talked to him today. He lives. He lives. My Jesus is alive. You may ask me how. I know he lives. He lives within my soul. He opened up. Yes, sir. And said, he on my way. Don't try to tell me. Just talk to him. He lives. He lives. lives. My Jesus is alive. You may ask me how. I know he lives. He lives within my soul. He opened up, good God, and set on my way. Don't try to tell me God is dead. Don't try to tell me God is dead. He woke me up this morning. Don't try to tell me it's not a lie. He opened up, good God, and set on my way. Don't try to tell me. I just talked to him today. Don't try to tell me, come on. He woke me up this morning. Don't try to tell me he's not alive. He opened up, good God, and set me. Don't try to tell me God is dead. Just talk to him. God is not dead, no. God is not dead, no. God is not dead, no. Feel him in my head. Feel him in my feet. Feel him all over me. Hey, hey, hey. God is not dead, no. God is not dead, no. God is not dead, no. Feel him in my head. Feel him in my feet. Feel him all over. Hey, God is not dead, no. God is not dead, no. God is not dead, no. Feel him in my hands. Feel him in my feet. Feel him all over. Yeah, yeah, yeah. God is not dead. Oh. Hey, God is not dead. God is not dead, no. Feel him in my hands. Feel him in my feet. Feel him all over. He's all over me. Hey. Anybody know that? Hey, keeping me up. Hey, it's keeping. And he's all over me. And he's keeping. Jesus is keeping me alive. I can feel him in my hands. And he's keeping. Hey, keeping. Oh, he's keeping. I can feel him in my hands, and he's keeping. Oh, Jesus is keeping me alive. I can feel him in my feet, and he's keeping. Oh, keeping. He's keeping me. I can feel him in my feet, and he's keeping. Oh, Jesus is keeping. Come on, somebody give him a praise in here. You believe it? He's still keeping you. Hallelujah. Through the wind and the rain, through the storm and the trials, come on. Jesus is keeping. Come on, one more time. Said he's all over me. That's right, that's right. Keeping. Yeah, he's keeping me. And he's all over me. And he's keeping. Woo! Jesus is keeping. One more time. Said he's all over me. Yes, he's keeping. The God so good. Hey, he's all over me and he's keeping. Hey, Jesus is keeping. Come on, give God some praise in here. You ready to praise him? Hey. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. My God, you got to have a praise on it. And know that you're really here to magnify God and put the devil to shame. Hello. My God. You ready to step in the devil face? Come on. Come on, put a step on it. Hallelujah. Warfare time. Hear my cry, oh God. Oh God. From the end of the earth. What God am I? When my heart is so, lead me, that is a yearning. Hear my cry, oh God. From the end of the earth. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me. That is a yearning. Higher, higher, higher. Hear my cry, oh God. Oh God. Hallelujah. From the end of the earth. Oh. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me. That is higher than I. For there has been and a mighty strong tower, and a strong tower. When my heart is overwhelmed, when my lead me, that is higher than I. Come on now, stop and let me tell you what the Lord has done for. What he did. Hey. Stop and let me tell you what the Lord has. Stop and let me tell you what the Lord has done for. What he did in my body, and then he, I stop and let me tell you what the Lord again. Stop and let me tell you. What he did, hear my body. Hey, stop and let me tell you. I know it was the blood. It said, I know it. It said, I know it. Save me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died. Hey, and I know it. I know it was the blood. It said, I know it. They said, I know it. Save me. One day when I was lost. Woo. And I know it. They said, I know it was the blood. They said, I know it. Lord said, I know it. Save me. Anybody know it? One day when I was lost. Woo. Oh, when I know. One more. Jesus is mighty. My monster. Yes, sir. I know he delivers me. How many now he? Tell me now. Tell me now. I know he delivers me. Tell him now. Woo! Oh God. Pinning on me back here. Tell him said it. Woo! Tell him said it. Pinning on me but he deliver. Tell him said it. Tell him said it. I know. One more. Sinful life he did. Hey, from my sinful life. Hey, from my sinful life. My God, I will not suffer. No, no. Tell him, tell him, tell him. God is my purpose. Oh God. Come on, say, I will not suffer. No, no. Tell him, tell him, tell him. God is my purpose. Oh God. Mommy, daddy, help. Good God, yes. Who's doing it for you? Hey, mommy, daddy, help. I will not beg, no. Mommy, daddy, help. Hey, mommy, daddy, help. I will not beg, no. One more time. I will not. No, no. Tell him, tell him, tell him. God is my purpose. Good God. Tell somebody else. I will not suffer. No, no. Who is providing for you? God is my purpose. Oh, yeah. Mommy, daddy, help. Oh, come on, dad. Oh, 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 oh. Hey. Mommy, daddy, help. My daddy, help. Hey, hey, hey. I will not beg, no. No, but I will not beg, no. Tell them, sir. No, sir. I will not beg. One more time. I will not beg no prayer. Come on, give him praise and glory. Glory to God. What a God know to provide for his people. Praise God. Hallelujah, we want to give you a chance to testify in the house. Because you know we love to hear the word, but we want to hear what the word is doing. Hallelujah, and that requires testimony. For the word of God said, we overcome the wicked one by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Yes, your time. Praise God.
Let's praise God. Hallelujah. Let us praise the Lord. I give God thanks for a beautiful day, a beautiful season, a beautiful time. Because such a time as this, the Lord has brought me to his kingdom. And I know that he hasn't started anything that he cannot finish. He doesn't start anything that he cannot complete. And I want to give him thanks this morning. I want to give him thanks for supplying my needs according to his riches in glory through Christ Jesus. I want to give him thanks for his son, Jesus Christ, who because of him and through him and in him, I am blessed in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I want to thank him because through Christ Jesus, I have salvation. You know, that has been giving us a lot of teaching, a lot. I was saying to the Lord last night that it is so much, Lord, that you have been teaching us through Apostle. So many things, and sometimes you don't remember everything, you know, but there is so much that can help us in our time of needs. And when the enemy tries to distress us, there is so much that we can learn from it. And one of the teaching that sticks with me now too, especially, is the one about our thoughts. That you are not the source of your thoughts. And then when Daddy was going over that last night, I was thinking to myself that we are not in control of our thoughts. But when the thoughts come to us, we have a choice. We have choices to make, whether we're going to go with the devil's thoughts and act it out, or the Lord's thoughts and act it out. And I was thinking that then that means you're not supposed to be sick. No, because if we start think on the word of God and think that the word of God is healing, and so we're not supposed to be sick. And I was thinking about persons in the house and myself and other things. And I was having a battle. You said the mind is our battlefield. And I was having a little warfare while we was worshiping, because there's no true worship, you say, without sacrifice.
That's right.
And the sacrifice will come through warfare, because you have to war to get what is really yours. You have to war to get the spoils. And so the enemy will come in like a flood, you know. But during the worship and the praise unto the Lord will lift up a standard against the enemy. And I'm just glad for this house that, I don't know, thank you, thing God called. I feel special. And I know I'm special. I feel like I'm in the house of the Lord. And I feel so important. I feel so good in my, I feel nice in the Lord, because the enemy will come with things, but you know that you can overcome. And if you think about everything that the Lord says in 1 Peter 3, and about verse Peter 3, about verse 3 there, where he said that he has given us all for life. And one of my favorite scripture that I use all the time, encourage my spirit man, I'm saying the Lord has given us all for life and godliness, so we don't have any excuse. He give us his house, he give us his people, he give us who he sent, he give us his word, he give us the Holy Spirit, he give us the angel for guard and guide us, and so many things he has given to us that we can stand, especially in these last days, because there are so many things that the enemy is using nowadays that will come against us. But I am not here to give him glory. I am not here to give him praise. I'm not even here to highlight him or talk about him. I'm here to tell you about the goodness of the Lord, because it's the goodness of the Lord I have to remind myself on a daily basis so that I can stand. Because I have to was saying to the Lord last night, Lord, you do too much for me. You know, give me a riffraff. So how me for give you a riffraff? I say, God, there are so many things that are coming against my mind and memory of this. And I say, Lord, me daddy tell me, say, you know, fight for nobody where you don't want. And you know, fight for nobody where you don't want. And you, and he said that anybody who wants you, you will not turn them away. And I want the Lord, because I am 51. I'm not ashamed to tell you that. I'm 51 years old, and I keep on saying to you, that these times are the best years of my life. Because when I think about all the other little things, them, you know, much people give up on me and dash away and walk on me and all kind of things, all kind of man and all kind of this and that. But God, people that out there fight all over man. Me, I fight for me, Jesus. Me, I fight over Jesus. Yes, people that out there fight for man. Me, I fight over Jesus. Because me know a man did do me. Me know a man did do me. This morning I was talking to somebody in the area in my house. I was talking to them, and we were talking about the economy and all of that. But I am saying to myself that no matter where you go, if you go on the car, if you go on a car, if you go on a good business, wherever you go, always find a way to intervene and to encourage somebody in the Lord. You know, make them just talk, because you see, if you make people just talk that are not in the Lord, and whatever they say will come, because words are powerful, you will be left with that. You must left them with something to man. So I started to give her my testimony. I started to tell her what God has done for me and what man do me. And that if I never came to this house and under the leadership that I am, my father never said to the doctor, send her a woman, whatever, I wouldn't be here to talk to her. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't be here to tell her about what God has done for me. And I said that I would be worrying about the economy. Because when you take $1,000 and buy one bread, you hardly have nothing left, can't even pay a fare. And I'd be worrying about that. But God said that my store basket will never be empty.
Amen.
God said that He will supply my needs according to His riches in glory through Christ Jesus. God said that I am healed. God said that I am His beloved. God said that I am precious in His sight. God said that I am the apple of His eyes. God said I am above and not beneath. God said I am blessed going out and coming in. God said that I am more than a conqueror. God said that I shall overcome. I'm not going under. God!
Yes, either.
God! God! Hallelujah. There's a song that says that sometimes you've got to encourage yourself.
Yes, yes.
And last night I heard Daddy say that sometimes him now got daddy, but we still don't hear your voice.
Yes.
Because you give us the word. And you have to lick left, right, and center and chop one, chop. Sometimes you have to chop blind. You have to just chop, because anything we're not for God, for chop out of your way. Because I want when Jesus come, I want him to hear, well done, good and faithful. Me no want a foolishness slip me out here. Me no want a foolishness lick me out of this place, sir, from God. Because what I had was foolishness. What I had was debt. The word of God said, the wages of sin is debt. But the gift of God is eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. And I know what I had was debt. I was in a line heading on to debt, heading on to hell and destruction, heading on where the devil is. And I realize it's the same fight him come with. Like he had from beginning, the same division he caused amongst the angel, let him get 1/3, the same thing he want with in the house of God. The same discard him coming. But we have to remember that the Lord says that he has given us more. More. It's always more in God. It's always more in God. You think that sometimes you get up and feel like you can't about come to church, but you're not live by feelings. We don't live by feelings, because when you don't have any fee for sex, you still give man because you want pleasure him. So what make you can't come give God praise? Me don't the sound feel the spirit of death come from me. I say, me have got dead in a style. Because me get up and I worship. Me get up and I sit down. No, because Satan, you make Satan come like him a rapist. Because Satan, when you lay down in bed, you know. Lay down in bed and say, you can't, you feel pain, you can't, but I got this man, and you can't, whatever. You want if you lay down there with him. But God... But God, we have to lean on the things. Persons work witchcraft against us. Persons send all kind of thing against us. But you cannot think on those things more than how you think on God and the word that you are giving to us. That's because right. If you sit down and think on the things that are coming against you more, then you're going to feel the impact of that. But if you dwell, the word of God says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Under the shadow of the Almighty, that was blessing. No curse, no daddy. He just want to prune us and equip us and train us and help us to be ready. To be ready, because you not take up anybody for come walk in your yard. So what make you want God take up anybody or anything for put in your kingdom? If you clean you up, wash you out, and prepare you and equip you and train you. So I'm glad for the word that you are giving to us. And I'm happy for the word of God in this house. Word out there. Other word out there. But what does it do to you? What does it do to you? I could have died. I should have died. I deserved that. But God. Mm-hmm. But God.
Yes.
But God. And I'm glad for today, for another chance to make a choice, to make that change, that transformation in my life, to give God glory, praise, and honor in His house amongst His people. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Come on, give God the praise. Hallelujah. Testimony time. Why hear more testimony in that place? And we know they are here, so we're not waiting. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Sometimes you have to encourage yourself. Sometimes you have to speak victory during the test. And no matter how you feel, speak the word and you'll be healed. Speak over yourself, encourage yourself in the Lord. I said sometimes you have to encourage yourself. Sometimes you have to speak victory during the word and you will be healed. Speak over yourself, encourage yourself in the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, this morning I'm standing here, and it's because of the grace of God. That's why I'm here this morning. I thank God for this holy house of prayer. I thank God for Apostle Richard Fagan. Because if it had not been for him this morning, I should be a crazy woman. I could be a dead woman. But because of God's grace, I can stand to testify of the goodness of God. God has been good to me. He is my comforter. He's my provider. He's my sustainer. He's my deliverer. He is my healer. He is my everything. He is my all in all. And this morning, I can bask in his goodness. I can bask in his love. You know, this morning, you know, from last night, you know, there was something in me. I said, I have to go to worship this morning. And you know, and I wake up this morning with this wonderful feeling within me. I just want to come here and worship. Because in the midst of all we are going through at such a time like this, we must find ourselves in the house of the Lord to worship him, to lift up his name, to exalt his name. Because I'm telling you, he has brought me from a mighty long way, and I can speak victory. I can speak victory because through it all, I have learned to trust in Jesus. I have learned to depend upon his word, and I'm standing on his word in Jesus' name.
Come on, give God a praise. The word of God is spirit, and it is life. It is what? Spirit and life, and there's power in the name of Jesus. And we got angelic hosts that encamp around us. We got the Holy Spirit. The word of God says that intercedes on our behalf through groanings that cannot be uttered, even when we don't know how to pray as we ought to. We have the Jesus seated at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us daily. Come on, somebody. You have men and women of God that God sent to build up your spirit in the Lord. Hallelujah, with the word of God. Hallelujah, with your testimony. And we got also, my God, the anointing that destroys every yoke and what? Lift every burden, my God. And if you work, you have so much working for you that you should win. Hello. So you should just use those tools to encourage yourself and understand that God has not left you in the fight defenseless. Praise God, but that he has standing there with you. He's a present help in the time of trouble. Therefore, you should believe, trust God, raise up your faith, and know that God is going to bring you out victorious. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Any more testimony in the house? We have 2 or 3 testimony. Yeah, no, we less than that.
Praise God. You know, I continue to give God thanks for this house, for this man of God. It's officially 2 years now since I've been here. And the things that God has been doing in my life, I can truly say that there's a transformation.
Praise God.
Transformation. Because when you look at it, persons can say they have been transformed. But when the life is manifesting and you see the change based on how you react to things differently now than you used to, that's how you know, as Paul says, comparing spiritual things with spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was living carnally. Even though I was professing to be a child of God, I was living carnally. But ever since I came into this house, the Lord has cut certain things off my life.
Mm-hmm.
And even people that I thought I could not live without. I never thought I could live without a wife.
Mm.
And I never thought I could live without friends. I used to go like begging persons to say, why are you leaving me? Why are you doing this? But then the Lord has built something in me.
Hallelujah.
To say that no matter what happens, Apostle always used this phrase when he's sometimes singing and even when he's giving a testimony, and he says, whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. And I've learned to adopt that, and not just to adopt it as a saying, but as a life. You understand? Because whatever it takes, and I was praying it the other night, and by the time I was going to open my mouth to say it, the Spirit of the Lord said, you know, that's a dangerous prayer. and I said, yes, Lord, I know it's a dangerous prayer. But then I lift my hands and say, whatever it takes, Lord. Yeah, man, I lift my hands and I came here and the apostle said the same thing. It's a dangerous prayer. And I have sat down and meditated on it and thought about it, because in Proverbs, Solomon says, it doesn't make sense to make a vow and then not keep your vow. Why should God destroy you? Because you have uttered something out of your mouth and you cannot keep it. And I said, Lord, whatever it takes. And that whatever, when you say that whatever, it releases something into the spiritual realm and the atmosphere, that the word that you have, the devil is coming against it to test that word.
Yes,
as Apostle was teaching, he did not come to test God's love for Job, but Job's love for God.
That's,
you understand?
True.
And yeah, man, my love for God has been tested. And every time it comes, I remember the word and I feast on the word and I meditate on the word and I remember the prayer, Lord, whatever it takes. Even when persons say, you know, I'm not going to be friends with you anymore, or I'm not coming where you are, I'm not going to uproot my life and what I have built to come and fit in your perfect world. That's not how it works. You know,
oh, Jesus.
I used to use that phrase. I know it's being used back to me. But I give God thanks. I give God thanks,
yes,
and I rejoice.
Yes.
I rejoice. I remember, you know, since I've been here, there are times when I fixate on dates. You understand? There are times when I fixate on dates. I love dates. And as I was sharing, I came here officially on the 24th of November. And every time during that week, God does something. He does things, you know, but there's some significant shift that takes place on that day. There are some significant shifts that take place within that week. And I've observed for the 2 years that I've been here, there are significant shifts that take place in my life during that week. You understand? And I look at it and I say, Lord, what? And he said, yeah, man, just keep doing it. Over the period of time, he's doing things, but there are significant shifts that take place during that time. And I've observed it. And even this week, I noticed something significant shifted. God has taken me to deeper depths in him where I don't harbor bitterness anymore.
Mm.
I don't harbor bitterness. Persons can do things and say things. And when I can stop and say, don't respond or don't say anything. If you know me, you know that I shoot first and ask questions later. But the Lord has changed that about me, where I can say, it doesn't matter what a person does, you may not be at the same place with them after they ask for forgiveness and you forgive them and they come back. You understand? But you don't hold it against them. You don't hold it and say, oh, you did this, so I'm not going to forgive you. I have passed that. And when the Lord showed it to me and said, you know, you used to behave like this, and now I can forgive. And I am at a place right now where I wish some persons would come back. I wish some persons would come back. You understand? Because it would show that they are listening to God and that God has worked on them. And if they truly repent, they will come back and say, listen, I want this. I messed up. I was tricked. I was seduced. But I want to come back. And when I look at that and I meditate on it and I say, Lord, this is not me. This is not how I used to do things, you know. You understand? But I look at it and I pray and I say, God, you are the one working in me. And he's working in my life financially. You know, God has provided. When things are low and I say, God, he just comes through. He comes through and he provides. You understand? He provides for me. He provides for my son. You understand? I have not bought clothes for my son in a long time. And every time I'm going to him, I have a bag of clothes, brand new clothes, shipped down from America, to give to him his right size and everything. You understand? So God provides for that. He provides food. He provides money. He provides things. But I'm not so much concerned about things, because I can make do with what I have. You understand? Mm-hmm. But God provides. And the most important thing is the word. The word that God is giving in my life. Because the word transforms. The word does its creative work in me. You can take away everything, but the word of God, when you have the word of God, you have everything. Because it is through the word of God, everything comes into existence. That's why God says he puts his word above his very name. You understand? Because his word is that powerful, that important to him. And nothing can be done without his word. And so when I look at that, they say the word is the most important thing. And here we have the word of life. Here we have the word which is life, which is spirit. And we are getting the word daily, undiluted. There's nothing being added or taken away. And when there's this thing that Isaiah talks about, and I see apostle doing it every time he's teaching the word. Line upon line, precept upon precept. Here a little, there a little. Always giving us the word, which is something that I appreciate, and I look into it. And the Lord says, he's not repeating himself, you know. He's not repeating. He's just making sure that line upon line, precept upon precept. So that when we get the word, we cannot say it's because we weren't fed properly why certain things happen. Because he's giving us the word daily. And I give God thanks for that. I give God thanks for the increase I've seen in my life. I give God thanks for my spiritual growth and how I relate to people. I give God thanks for that. And I give God thanks for the man of God who continues to be faithful and obedient to God. Faithful and obedient to God. And I remember the Lord said something to me some months ago. When Apostle was saying, you know, people are looking for him to sin or to say, because, you know, you have that mindset when you're in religion that, yeah, man, something in a secret, something in a corner, we not tell we. You understand? That's a religious mindset. But every time he mentions it, the Lord says to me, yes, and you can say it too. You can say it too. And I say, he say, yes, you can say it. Say it. Open your mouth and say it. I will never sin again. Open your mouth and say, that's what the Lord said to me. Open your mouth and say it. I will never sin again.
Amen.
You understand? Yeah, man, he bore that witness in my spirit. And he says, it's not only for Apostle Richard Fagan. It is for the body of Christ, because he says, whosoever is born of God does not sin. It did not say apostles, pastors, and evangelists alone. It says whosoever does not sin. So it's for all of us who are in the body of Christ. And I hold on to that. And the Lord said, once you stay in the word, you will never go astray. You know that word never? People say never say never. Well, I can say it. When you stay in the word, you will never go astray. Praise. Never go astray. And the Lord bore bear witness to that in my spirit. And he said, you will never go astray if you abide in the word. God bless you.
Come on, give God the praise. Give God the praise. Yes, man, let praise rise on the inside, man. Praise God. We're going to do some worship to change the atmosphere in the room. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, lift those hands to Jesus. Let praises rise on the inside, on the inside of me. May you delight on the inside, on the inside of me. Come fill my life from the inside, from the inside of me. By your fire, set me on fire on the inside, on the inside of me. All I want, come on, is for you, you to be glorified, you to be lifted. All I want is for you, you to be glorified, you to be lifted high. Let praises rise, come on church, from the inside, from the inside. May you delight on the inside. Hallelujah. On the inside. Set me on fire, oh God, on the inside. Hallelujah. May you delight on the inside. Woo! Glory to God. All I want is for you, you to be glorified, you to be lifted. All I want, come on, is for you, you to be glorified, you to be lifted. Come on, all I want, all I want is for you, you to be glorified. All I want, all I want is for you, you to be glorified. Fill my life till all they see is you, Lord. Anybody want that in here? Lift your hand and declare. Fill my heart till all they see is you, Lord. Fill my heart, fill my heart till all they see. Glorify your name. Fill my heart till all they see. Come on, lift those hands and sing. Glorify your name. Woo, glory to God. Glorify your name. Yes, Lord. Glorify your name. Woo. Do you want him to glorify? Glorify your name, Roshe Master. Hallelujah. Glorify your name. Good God. In all of this, glorify your name, my God. All for the sake of the cause. Glorify your name. Ooh. Yes, Lord. Glorify your name. Is that your desire today? Glorify. Glorify your name, Lord. Woo. Yes, Lord. Glorify your name. Woo. Woo. Hallelujah. Come on, worship him, worship him. Let your heart rise to him right now. We want you to glorify him, Lord. Anybody want to see his glory? You've seen enough of what the devil can do. But you just yield to him and say, Lord, glorify your name in this. Your name is a strong tower. Hey, glorify your name. Hey, your name is a strong refuge. Hey, glorify your name. Oh, glorify your name. Ooh. Anybody. Yeah. Ooh. Hallelujah. As the deer panted for the water brooks, so my soul longed after thee. Ooh. So be glorified, oh God. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and Nothing is too hard for you, Lord. Oh, Shemas. With you, all things are possible. Hallelujah. Come on, anybody got a worship in here? Huh? Hallelujah. Hey. You know, hey, you're the all-seeing, all-knowing, all-wise God, almighty, all-powerful, glorious, excellent, perfect God. Hey, so glorify your name. Your name, glorify your name. Woo! Glorify your name. Don't say mercy. Hey, glorify. I want you to glorify. I live for you to glorify. Hey, glorify your name. Anybody? Hey, glorify your name, Babosha. Said, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away. And behold, all things have become new. We embrace that anointing, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Let it flow, let it flow. Let it flow, let it flow. Let it flow, let it flow. Yeah. And glorify your name. Whoa. Glorify your name. Whoa. Good God. Come on, somebody give him praise. In here. Hallelujah. 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 Hey. Did you come to worship him? Did you come to worship him? Hallelujah. 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 Hey. Yes, Lord. Ooh. Yes, Lord. Oh, Shama. Glorify your name. Ooh. Glorify your name. Ooh. Glorify your name. Glorify your name. Hey. Come on, somebody. Step into the glory. Ha. step into the glory. Hey. Hey. Your name. He brought us in that name. He redeemed us for that name. He saved us through that name. There is power in that name. Life in that name. Somebody, Kosha. Somebody. Need a call. Let faith arise. Power in the name. Yeah. Power in the name. Woo. Power in the name. Oh, Shema. Power in the name. Hey. Hey. Mountains move. Chains are broken. Hey. Hey. Weights are lifted. Koshabasa. In that great name. Somebody call him. Are you ashamed to call on the Lord? Hey! Hallelujah! Jesus! Jesus! Hallelujah! 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 Cut and clear the way. Disappoint the enemy's plans. Overturn the enemy. Overturn the table of conspiracy. Yeah. And give us the victory, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, oh. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Come on, share the best. Hallelujah! Something is lifted in the air right now. Kilawashi masa. Anointing be released. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. Whatever God want to do, just agree. Hallelujah. Let him have his way. Go to Rabba send it. Let him have his way. Go to Rabba send it. Hallelujah. Hey. For many are the plans of men, but it's the purposes of God that will stand. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. Woo. Hey. I wait on you, Lord. I wait on you, Lord. I wait on you, Lord. Worship. I wait on you, Lord. Worship, mama, mama, I wait on you, Lord. At your footstool. Humbly at your feet. You make me complete. Yeah. Nothing missing. Nothing broken. Disappoint me. You never let me down. That's why I trust you. That's why I wait on you. Yeah. Yes, Lord. We glorified. Anybody want to see his glory in this house tonight? Come on, come on, come on. Come on, you got to get pressed beyond yourself. Get out of that shell and get into that presence. Glory, 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 glory. Come on, come on. Come on, worship him in the house. Hallelujah. You got a worship in you. Oh, shatara baba basi toroshi. Kiki wo shama. Hey. In the presence of the King. In the presence of the risen one, splendor and glory. Oh, holy, holy. In the presence of the King. Hey. In the presence of the risen one, there is splendor and glory. Angels crying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Woo! Holy is the Lord. Come on, somebody. Holy is the Lord. Shama. Hey. Holy is the Lord. In the presence of the King. In the presence of the risen one. There is splendor and glory. Just crying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Come on, holy is the Lord. Yeah. Holy is the Lord. Yeah. Holy is the Lord. come on. We are before him. Oh, I'm a seat. Draw near to him. Don't be afraid. He's calling you for this purpose. To make his dwelling in you. Ooh. Ooh. Thank you, Lord. Good God, good God. Come on, come on, come on, get deeper. Forget about what's happening around you. And focus on him. Roshabasitu. Presence, there's fullness of joy. Come on, you got your joy. Draw from him, there is endless supply. Hey. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Crying, holy, holy is the Lord. And crying, holy, holy is the Lord. Crying, holy, holy is the Lord. They're crying, holy, holy is the Lord. 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 Holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord. Devotion. Holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord. Oh God. The Lord, holy is the Lord, holy is the Lord, holy, 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 holy. Holy, we must be holy. We must be. Holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord. Come on, worship him in the house. Anybody got a worship in the house?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
my God, come on, you can be better than that. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, Shabbasi. Hallelujah. Oh, Shabbas. In his presence. Come on. Are you happy for his presence? Don't take his presence for granted. Hallelujah. For David said, cast me not away from your presence. And take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. And sinners shall be converted unto thee. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. The sinners need to know there's such a joy that they can't get from worldly things. Woo! That is only found in the Lord. Somebody praise him in the house. Somebody give him a genuine praise. Woo! Thank you, Lord. Woo! That's what I'm talking about. Woo! The atmosphere is charged with his presence. Ah, oh Lord. Oh Lord. How excellent is your name in all the earth. In all the earth. Hallelujah. Come on, worship him, somebody. I love him, I love him. I can't get tired of worshiping him. Hallelujah. He's the joy of my salvation. He's the light of my life. He's the strength of my life. Hallelujah. Somebody give him glory. Somebody give him glory. Thank you, Lord. Come on, give him praise.